Just 5 days until Election Day, U.S. Senator Russ Feingold is fighting to keep his seat in the Senate. Good evening, I'm John Stofflet.
And I'm Lee Mills. In your Decision 2010 news, polls show Feingold trailing or running even with Republican challenger Ron Johnson.
Tonight, NBC 15's Zach Schultz sits down with both candidates as we approach Election Day.
In the first part of our look at the U.S. Senate race between Russ Feingold and Ron Johnson, we'll focus on the economic issues facing the nation.
Ron Johnson's campaign is based on a pretty simple theme.
The economy is being stifled because of the total out-of-control spending and debt of this federal government.
This may be the only place where Russ Feingold agrees with Johnson. The difference is who they blame.
I voted against all this Wall Street bailout and all these Wall Street scams. And I always opposed the heavy deficit spending that led us into this mess in the first place.
Johnson says Feingold's support of health care reform will only do more damage to the economy.
I do believe that's the greatest single assault on our freedom in my lifetime. I believe it is designed to lead to a single-payer, government-run health care system like Canada. It's exactly what Senator Feingold wants.
Johnson also attacks the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act, or stimulus.
The stimulus package failed. It was supposed to create, according to Senator Feingold, 2.4 million jobs in the first year.
Feingold says voters were lied to about those bills.
Well, they were given intentionally the wrong information by people like Mr. Johnson and the various groups that completely fabricated what the bill did. It was the most awful distortion I've ever seen in politics on both of these bills.
But he says voters are seeing the benefits as early provisions of the health care bill start working and stimulus projects get completed.
We're gradually winning the battle on both of those bills. Those were the right votes, and I stand by them.
Feingold was first elected to the Senate in 1992. He says the real economic problem is trade agreements for the last two decades that let jobs leave the state.
Mr. Johnson, my opponent, is strongly for these trade deals. He said they were good for the economy. He actually calls them creative destruction.
Johnson is a plastics manufacturer from Oshkosh who sells many of his products overseas.
We certainly do need free trade, but we need fair trade. And I certainly, as an exporter myself, I'll recognize what fair trade is. And I will fight to make sure that the trade agreements that we'd sign in the future would be fair.
Johnson says what the federal government needs is a hard spending cap and a balanced budget.
You know, force the agencies to justify every dollar spent every year. You know, things like hiring freezes, spending rollbacks. And that's how you actually start bringing discipline and start cutting spending.
Feingold says Johnson's plan is nothing more than slogans.
He's trying to very quietly get into the United States Senate without telling us how he's going to cut spending, without telling us how he's going to create jobs.
Zach Schultz, NBC 15 News.
Tomorrow night at 6, Zach examines some of the other issues in the race for Senate, including stem cell